broke ground through Brighton first. Electrical bill for the car is really going to go up.
You get an electrical bill.
We don't? Down Brighton overlooking the scenic Grand River.
You get right? The sound on? It's always on. Can't shut it off.
That's a good job. band you just stand up in here, Joe. That one's Ronnie Millsap up next for you right now at 7:56.
The FBI's abscam sting has resulted in another conviction, this time a U.S. senator, the fourth conviction of a senator in office in U.S. history. Carol DiIorio reports Harrison Williams does not plan to step down.
New Jersey Senator Harrison Williams says he will not resign from the post he has held for the past 1 to 2 years. Following his conviction on robbery and conspiracy charges last night, he said he was disappointed but insisted he is innocent.
I know my lawyer in the beginning. He's worked with me every day for a year and a half almost. I told him I had done nothing wrong, and I felt that George Holder, after knowing all of my activities, felt the same way.
Prosecutor Thomas Puccio accused Williams of using his political office for his own personal gain. He said the evidence was overwhelming and the verdict was just. Cal DiIorio, New York.
More rioting today in the streets of Northern Ireland in both Londonderry and Belfast. That comes with the dramatic backdrop of Bobby Sands' death watch. The jailed IRA guerrilla is still near death.
Like, you gotta make your own boat out of something like milk jugs to float on or something?
Yeah.
Well, that, you know, Tom's optical over there in the Mill Creek office building?
Yeah.
That Bob owns? Well, his kid is in one of my classes. His brother and me are in, going to be in a race. They sent letters to all the store people.
The SS Norway remains still without power about 500 miles southeast of Miami. 1,800 vacationers are aboard, and they're to be transferred to a sister ship later today. Some House Democrats say there are some conservatives in their ranks who want to rethink their support of the Reagan administration economic plan. But GOP leaders apparently refuse to pledge. They feel confident they'll give the White House a budget victory. In the House, debate over the budget will take up Monday. Yesterday, Congressman Thomas Wiley of Virginia, a Republican, said the current economic trouble is, as the administration says, pegged to federal spending.
The history of our economic illness is quite clear. The federal government is the culprit. Under the guise of some back-to-back years of double-digit inflation, for the first time since World War I.
House Speaker Ronnie